I'm Rui from Portugal. Basically, my bartender history started a few years ago while I was in university. So I was studying nothing to do with hospitality. So I was studying civil engineering and had to start finding a job to help to pay for the bills, the university. And I started working in a bar just out of a curiosity, a friend of a friend. Oh, I need someone to help doing a shift. And I went there. And after that, the boss was so happy with me, asked me to start working with them. And that's basically when started my journey in bartending. Back in Portugal, it was not a very deep knowledge that I was getting in terms of bartending. Learned how to do a couple of cocktails, a mojito, some fruity gins, these kind of things. But then once again, out of a curiosity, a friend of a friend spoke with me about a job opportunity in London to work for Marriott as a bartender. And well, I never thought about leaving my country, to be honest with you, but the situation was not that good in there financially. So I just, okay, in a couple of weeks, I decided to leave everything behind and come to London. And that's when it started in Marriott Canary Wharf. I had an amazing team in there, really experienced bartenders with such knowledge that when I arrived, I even asked myself in the first days, what am I doing in here with these people? And then the journey just started a little bit kind of by itself, getting the people that I was with me, sharing the knowledge, sharing the passion that they were having for the drinks, for the beverage itself. And it started little by little, obviously, with a lot of effort. What I say to my bartenders nowadays as well, is kind of just what we do while we're working or anything is not enough to get what we need to do this job. We need to actually put some passion and develop some time into it to learn, to get to understanding what the drinks are, what we can do with them, how we can play around with them. That's an infinite way of going around and make it work. And once again, everyone has their own taste, so you can basically adapt anything to please anyone. And as it started, well, that passion started actually growing in inside of me, and obviously start taking some degrees. Went to take a bartender European school on advanced mixology, studying. I made some trips to Scotland to visit basically majority of the distilleries up north in Ireland, Speyside, Islay, everywhere that I travel. I always like to go and try to know the locals and what are the type of things that they are doing in there with their drinks, visit the local distilleries, local breweries, and all of that obviously helping my journey to develop my knowledge, to be able to please my guests as well, to have an extended menu list that's going to abrange a lot of people and their likes. And yeah, and all of that journey start growing inside of the company as well, from a bartender to then to a shift leader, then to move to where I am now at Marriott County Hall, where I started as a head bartender. And now at the moment, I'm managing both the restaurant and the bar in there.
Let's define a good bartender. You know, who's a good bartender to you?
Well, a good bartender for me, there's a lot of things that he needs to have. First of all, one of them, obviously, the knowledge of the products that you're offering to your guests, a deep understanding as well, a knowledge and a lot of try. This comes with a lot of try as well. But the kind of blends, the mixes, the concussions that you can do, what works well with what, that comes with a lot of practice as well. And obviously you have to have one thing that's it's most difficult to teach anyone, that needs to come from you as well, is the passion from what you do and making sure that you make people happy, because in this business you're actually just creating, putting your knowledge, putting your creativity into pleasing the people that's coming to visit you and making sure that they come again. So having that passion to make someone happy, make someone enjoying the moment and the creations that you are having, I think that's one of the most important things that you need to have as a bartender.
What about a good bar? How do you rate a bar?
One of the most important things for me in a bar is the atmosphere. To create the atmosphere, you need to have the passion people behind it. I always say this since I start working, that a bar is not made by its name, it's made by the people that work at it. And so one of the things that I rate the bar, obviously, it's going to be the quality of the drinks, especially if you're going for cocktails. That tells a lot of the knowledge of the people working in there and what they are doing, and the type of service that they provide you. how friendly they are, how welcoming they are, how well they make you feel apart just from the drink that you're going to be having. So that, I think, is a very important part that bartenders play inside of a bar, which is how welcome they make you feel, how at home they make you feel in their place.
What's your predictions for the, you know, top three category growth? You know, like which category you think in alcohol drinks will do well?
Rum has been showing quite a nice upbringing again as well. To be honest with you, I'm very curious because it's something it's been working and it's been growing a lot around the world as well. And I know that you know about it because I've been following you on LinkedIn and everything. All these new trends on hemp drinks, especially on wines as well. I think that's in the next few years. It's something that it's gonna be growing a lot. Even yesterday, I was talking with a friend of mine who's working in Thailand. They just legalized weed in there as well. That are starting making into food industry and the drinks industry as well. So I think that's gonna be one of the things that's gonna be growing the most in 2023.
What is one of the bizarre thing that comes to your mind that a customer has said to you at the bar?
No, but one one that I do remember that I was a bit shocked and I didn't know how to answer that was a guest that I was having at the bar that all of a sudden after we've been talking for a while and preparing some drinks, the guest just turned to me and asked me, sorry for asking this, but is there any chance that you can find me a tampon? To be honest with you, I had to stop for like 5 seconds to try to understand, is this any word that I don't know what it means? She actually asked me for a tampon, and I really had to turn to her and said, sorry, are you really asking for this, or is there any that other
drink name or a cocktail name
that I do not understand? And then she said that it was actually that she was trying to find. So I had to go to one of my female colleagues to ask if she could help me with that. But I think that in terms of bizarreness, I think that was one of the most bizarre questions that I had working behind the bar.
How many cocktails recipes do you know, like just, you know, on top of your head, where you don't have to read or nothing, you just can make it?
100% without bringing that question, oh, is this 10 or 15 ml on this? I would say around 15, 20 on top of my head that I would be extremely confident on doing without raising any question in my head.
And what are your top three like selling cocktails at your bar?
Well, in my bar on the list, we have bespoke cocktails, all created by the bartenders. But on the classic ones, I would say that's a Negroni, Pornstar Martini, and French 75.
And what should we order at your bar? You know, as a first guest, I say, hey, you recommend me, you know, you tell me what should I order?
So one that I would go that I really do like, it's what we call a bespoke one that we have, it's called the James Groni. So it's a slightly twist on the Negroni. We use our very own Gires gin that I've created a couple of years ago. We only have it at the hotel, to be served in the hotel. Instead of the Campari, we use Aperol. And instead of the vermouth, I use a bit of Grand Marnier and port wine.
Your go-to cocktail bars and why?
Cocktail bars, I like to go to try to, first of all, to actually go and try to new things, to see what the other place, once again, kind of a market research as well to see what other people are doing in other places. Once again, I look for a nice place, a nice atmosphere to go and enjoy a drink with a company that I'm with. I'm not the kind of person that likes to go alone to the bar. I like always to have a company with me, to have a chat, to enjoy a little bit of a good time. So yeah, the one of the main reasons is try to enjoy a nice cocktail and see what's going on and happening in the rest of the industry as well.
What's your tip for men out there to offer women few drinks, a free drink? You know, how would you approach, how would you tell a bartender, how would you, you know, get that free drink over to her?
Well, I would say for the bartender, it would say, first of all, just to whatever the lady is having that she likes, because it's a very tough thing without knowing anyone to know what they like.
Got it.
So that I would leave for the bartender to have his imagination, his knowledge on the person, and just saying that a nice gesture from this gentleman over here. And then we always approach the reaction of the person when she gets the drink. And then it's up to you, not up to the bartender anymore.